Okay, so chances are that if you're stuck at home right now, you're watching one heck of a lot of TV. But one thing I've really started to notice is that subscription TV services are just popping up like wildfire everywhere. Like, I mean, sometimes when you get your cable, you can get like this on demand and it has some channels, but a lot of other people want to watch more stuff beyond that, and the stuff that's not available on there, well, they're starting to subscribe to. We've got the new Disney Plus, we've got the new DC. Honestly, I mean, even if you have Amazon Prime, there's Acorn TV, there's BBC TV, there's Fox, ABC. Like, pretty much no matter where you're going, you're paying money to watch TV. A lot of people are doing this. And what I'm finding out is it's really, honestly, frustrating. A lot of it is a complete, total, utter ripoff. So if I was going to go to my top TV service that I, you know, want to keep because I use it all the time, that would have to be Netflix. Netflix keeps pouring out content. A lot of it's crap, obviously. It's foreign language, weird stuff. And you're like, what the am I just watching? You know what I mean? But still, there's a lot of good cartoons and a lot of stuff. So in Netflix, even though I got to pay them, and I would have to say at this point for HD, they are my most premium service that I'm paying for. It's like 14 something bucks for my Netflix account, which if you think about it, it's pretty expensive. That's, you know, that's quite high. I mean, it's not as much as your electricity, gas, or anything like that, but still, $14.95 a month, you know, for whatever, for something you just watch on TV is expensive, you know? And then if you don't really have any type of TV or whatever, Hulu can actually be pretty cool because it has live sports and stuff like that. So those two right there, from my perspective, are kind of okay. You know, paying for them's okay, but I'm already paying for Amazon Prime. And here's what's weird about Amazon Prime. So you get all these channels that are supposedly Amazon Prime channels, right? But then they've got all these additional services. So like if you like crime drama, you got to pay for crime drama. You want comedy? You pay for comedy. You want BET? You pay for BET. You want sports? You pay for sports. Everything that you're doing, you're being really completely and utterly nickeled and dimed. I mean, literally nickeled and dimed for your money with all of these different TV subscription services. I mean, it's just absolutely nuts. Now, my problem really is with Disney Plus and with DC, and I'm gonna tell you why, okay? Obviously, if you have children, then maybe Disney Plus may last you 3 months before you run out of things to watch. I'm just being honest here. I got the Disney Plus. I watched the first season of The Mandalorian. That was pretty cool, but it's only a half an hour show. So like, it's really, come on, a half an hour for a show like that? Come on, Disney, that's just weak sauce, weak butt sauce. Make the show at least an hour long, okay? But all the rest of the content, all the old movies, the cartoons, and all that stuff, I literally went through all that stuff kicking back with my mom while we were downtime, and we went through all that kind of stuff. So that now you're like basically paying $7 a month just for a new episode of The Mandalorian. I mean, that's it, because there is really no real true new content. You're not getting constant new programs with Disney. You know what I mean? And even when like a new Disney movie comes out, it's not like they're putting it on the channel that you're paying for. And this is where my pet peeve comes in, these idiot con artists. So like, you're paying for Disney Plus, but Disney releases Aladdin 15. Do you think you're going to get Aladdin 15 with the service that you're paying for? Hell to the nose, you're not going to get paid for it. I mean, you're not going to be getting it for free. You're going to be paying for it separately. So you're paying this service already. You think, oh, wow, you know, I'm paying Disney Plus the service, like a new Disney thing came out. My kids are going to be able to watch it. No, no, they're not. Not unless you want to go pay either 19 bucks to buy it, or you want to pay like between $3.99 and $5.99 to rent it, depending on where the heck it's at. And even this is nuts. You guys got to see this. Check this out. This is a rental on Amazon Prime for $19, bro. A rental. Rental. We're not talking about buying. We're talking about a one-time watch feature for you at 19 bucks. Now, give and take, if it was a brand new movie that just hit the movie theater yesterday and you can't go to the movie theater, maybe $19 if you have a family isn't that bad. But for me, I'm a single guy. Like, you know what I mean? For me, I'm paying, you know, that much money to watch a movie one time. Right? Brand new Vin Diesel movie came out, man. I was like, oh man, this blood movie sounds pretty good. I want to watch it. Got halfway decent ratings. I mean, ratings, you know, but it's Vin Diesel. So, you know, the idea of paying, no offense, Vin, love you, baby, but I'm just not into paying $19 to see a Vin Diesel movie one time and not own it. It's just ridiculous. That's crazy. So all of these different things has just gotten ridiculous. Having to pay one price premium for your TV stations and then having to pay like every single solitary dollar for every type of category you want to watch is just gotten out of hand. I mean, it is simply ridiculous. And really, 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 DC. Oh, DC pisses me off. Okay, so check it out. I subscribe to the DC channel thinking, okay, this is cool. It's got some cool programs. I would definitely want to check out these new programs. You know, I'm totally into Nightwing. So I'm like, oh man, I can see Nightwing in action. All right, then, you know, that shiznik sounds pretty good. So, you know, I went into it. Within a month, I'd watched everything on there. And then I got to this program called Krypton, okay? Now, mind you, this is DC's so-called awesome service. Oh, we're DC, we're badass, we're super people. BS. I had to actually pay money separately to watch the second season of Krypton. I mean, what the heck is up with that? I mean, I'm already paying these guys $8 a month. It's not like it's a brand new show. Why isn't it even on their channel? And then just recently, they released Superman Red Sun. Could I watch it on my DC subscription? No, I couldn't watch it on my DC subscription whatsoever. Not at all. So before we move on, let's real quick though hear a word from today's sponsor, Busy Future, real quick. These guys sell Windows Pro keys. They're under $20. All of them work. Many of my readers have used them before. Many of the people who come to the site have tried them and left messages saying, hey, this stuff works absolutely great, so there's really no risk. You buy any antivirus pack, and there's packs as low as $15, you actually get a free Windows 10 key. So we'll have a link down below. Check that out. All right, now that that's out of the way. So anyways, like I've been saying this entire video, things have really gotten out of hand in the subscription pay service for TV. And $19 for a rental, I don't know, man. That's just really hard for me to swallow. Being an individual who lives by himself, like it's not like I can call a bunch of people and go, hey, come on over. Let's all chip in a buck and let's watch this movie, you know, over here, you know, off of Amazon Prime's rental services. It's just nuts. And Disney has very limited content, honestly. Once you go through all their older Star Wars movies and stuff, you're done. And is even the newest, like, Star Wars titles, were they even on there? No. No. You had to wait and wait and wait and wait and wait and wait and wait. So, I don't know. To me, that's just nuts. And paying a monthly fee just for The Mandalorian for a half-hour show, that's like what I'm doing right now with DC, where I'm into Harley Quinn. So, a 22-minute show is really the only thing on there that I'm paying for now. Get it? 22 minutes, $8 a month, so $24.60, $80. So I guess, I mean, I don't know, I guess you want to add it up. I guess I'm paying $8 for less than 2 hours of content for something to do. I don't know. Maybe it's not a total complete ripoff, depending on how you look at it, but to me, it really is. After you've done these subscriptions and watched through everything, what's the point of being subbed to them? This is how I've ended up doing stuff. Like, I just subscribed to this channel called Epics. $5.99 for a 30-day trial, right? Well, within this 30-day trial, I'll watch everything that's on Epix. You know what I mean? So during the 30-day trial, I'll watch everything that's on Epix, you know, all the series and stuff. And that's cool if I get really, really hooked on some series. All I have to do is just cancel the subscription. And then finally, when they actually bring back the second or third seasons in the full length of these programs, then I might go back and sub for a month and watch those programs I really want to watch. But there is just so much content and so much stuff out there to choose from. It's just crazy. You could literally spend your entire paycheck just on digital download stuff. Honestly. And music? Hey, that's a whole other ballpark. We'll talk about it some other time. But, you know, as far as movies, TV goes, I don't know if they're just totally just taking advantage of things because we're all stuck at home right now because of the quarantine. But stuff has gotten ridiculous. I'm pretty much going to be canceling all of my paid subscriptions except for Netflix right now. And if I like what I'm seeing on Epix, maybe I'll continue it. But right now, I really see myself only paying them. I pay my Prime every year. It's now like $120, and you get to watch a lot of different Prime, you know, TV channels. They have some cool stuff on there. I will say that, you know, Amazon TV programs are actually really quality well made. If you like Bosch, if you like, you know, The Boys, there's just all kinds of actual, even so many more. I mean, honestly, I think Amazon has good TV. Only Amazon, to me, is giving really Netflix, I think, a run for really quality programs that you're paying for that's like in a built-in thing. You know what I'm saying? And I'm sick of paying for one channel to watch British TV, one channel to watch Swedish TV, one channel to watch this, one channel to watch that. They are nickel and diming us to death, my friends. Let me hear what you guys think. But personally, I think that things have gotten completely out of hand and we're really being ripped off in the most slickest, slyest method ever. Because you know what they're doing? They're touching on your base need for entertainment. And guess what? We all fall victim to it. I fall victim to it. I admit it. We all do. But is it right? No. I think it's totally wrong. Paid subscription TV, if you're paying somebody some money for a TV, it should probably include at least, you know, a substantial amount of the same type of genre that you like. It shouldn't just be, you know, you're paying for all these different things. I, like usual, I want to hear what you guys have to say. We finally did get a new film place built. We're not totally done with it, but it's looking better than that ugly-ass egg white stuff we had on the wall right on. So, hey, thanks for watching the video. If you like what you see, hey, we'd love to see you backers. You can hit that sub button. If you'd like to help keep the channel going, you can try Amazon Prime. It's free for 30 days. You can watch all their stuff in 30 days and watch a ton of programs. I recommend The Boys. Awesome program. Seriously. Try it for 30 days. Watch their TV. Cancel it. Hey. Right? Helps me. You can watch some cool stuff. We're all in it together. Also, if you got some extra cash and you want to see us stick around, you can support us by a single dollar over on Patreon. I'm Elric. You guys have been watching Tech of Tomorrow. I think that paid TV has gotten out of hand and we're all getting royally screwed by these companies. What do you think?